Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyambal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject fluid mechanics in machines. This is lecture number 4.5. We are going to solve problems in the fluid kinematics. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the theoretical concepts of the fluid kinematics like velocity, acceleration, circulation, vorticity, velocity potential function, steam function, flow net, vortex flow, free vortex flow, forced vortex flow. So all the theoretical concepts we have discussed. So in this lecture, we solve problems from the Anna University question paper. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems in the fluid kinematics. The first example number 1 from November 2009 question paper. Find the velocity and acceleration at a point 1, 2, 3 after 1 second for a 3-dimensional flow field given by u equal to yz plus t, v equal to xz minus t and w equal to xy. So the given flow field, 3-dimensional flow field u equal to yz plus t, v equal to xz minus t and w equal to xy at the point x equal to 1, y equal to 2, z equal to 3 and time t equal to 1 second. So the values of the velocity vector. So u equal to yz plus t, substituting 2 into 3 plus 1 equal to 7, v equal to xz minus t, so 1 into 3 minus 1 equal to 2, w equal to xy, that is 1 into 2 equal to 2. So the velocity v equal to square root of u square plus v square plus w square, where velocity equal to substituting numerical values, v equal to square root of 7 square plus 2 square plus 2 square equal to square root of 57, which is 7.55. Here u, v, w are the velocity vector in the x, y, z directions. The acceleration at x equal to 1, y equal to t, 2, z equal to 3 and t equal to 1. So we are given u, velocity vector in the x direction, y, z plus t. So now we differentiate. Dou u by dou x equal to 0, dou u by dou y equal to z, dou u by dou z equal to y and dou u by dou t equal to 1. So these are all the partial derivative of the various parameters. Now ax, acceleration in the x direction, it is given by u into dou u by dou x plus v into dou u by dou y plus w into dou u by dou z plus dou u by dou t. So substituting all the values, ax equal to 7 into 0 plus 2 into z plus 2 into y plus 1. So numerical values, substituting numerical values, 7 into 0, 2 into z equal to 3 plus 2 into y equal to 1 and this equal to 11. Similarly, velocity component v equal to xz minus t. So at x equal to 1, y equal to 2, z equal to 3 and t equal to 1. Now dou v by dou x equal to z. Dou v by dou y equal to 0, dou v by dou z equal to x and dou v by dou t equal to minus 1. Now velocity component in the acceleration component in the y direction, u into dou v by dou x plus v into dou v by dou y plus w into dou v by dou z plus dou v by dou z, dou v by dou t. So substituting ay equal to u equal to 7, dou v by dou x equal to z plus 2 into dou v by dou y equal to 0 plus 2 into w equal to 2. Dou v by dou z equal to x minus 1, dou v by dou t equal to minus 1. So substituting numerical values, ay equal to 7 into 3 plus 2 into 0 plus 2 into 1 minus 1 equal to 22. Then the third component in the z direction, dou w by dou x equal to y, so dou w by dou y equal to, w equal to xy, dou w dou x equal to y, dou w by dou y equal to x, dou w by dou z equal to 0, dou w by dou t equal to 0. And az equal to u into dou w by dou x plus v into dou w by dou y plus w into dou w by dou z plus dou w by dou t. So substituting value 7 into y plus 2 into x plus 2 into 0 plus 0. Substituting numerical value 7 into 2 y equal to 2 plus 2 into 1 plus 2 into 0 plus 0 equal to 16. So the acceleration a equal to capital A equal to square root of ax square plus ay square plus az square, which is square root of 11 square plus 22 square plus 16 square equal to square root of 861, which is 29.34 meter per second square. So acceleration is 29.34 meter per second square. The example number 2, in a three-dimensional flow, incompressible fluid flow, the elastic component in the x and y directions are u equal to x square minus y square into z cube plus and v equal to minus of xy plus yz plus zx. Use the continuity equation to evaluate the expression is a velocity for the elastic component in w, elastic component w in the z direction. So this is from May 2010 and November 2009 question paper. So, given data u equal to x square plus y square into z cube, v equal to minus of xy plus yz minus plus zx. So, from the expression for u equal to x square plus y square plus y square into z cube, dou u by dou x equal to 2x. Similarly, velocity component v minus of xy plus yz plus zx, dou v by dou equal to minus x minus z. So, the continuity equation dou u by dou x plus dou v by dou y plus dou w by dou z equal to 0. So, substituting dou u by dou x equal to 2x, dou v by dou y equal to minus x minus z plus dou w by dou z equal to 0. So, from the expression dou w by dou z equal to z minus x. So, 2x minus x equal to x plus x. So, z minus x. Now, the velocity component, the velocity component w in the z direction, dou w by dou z equal to z minus x. From the previous page, dou w by dou z equal to z minus x. Now, integrating the equation, w equal to integral z minus x dz. So, z square by 2 minus xz plus a constant which is function of x and y. So, the velocity component w in the z direction is z square minus 2, less z square by 2 minus xz plus a constant of integration. Example number 3, the velocity potential function for a two-dimensional flow is given by phi equal to x into 4xy minus 3. 1. Determine the velocity at a point 2, 3. Determine the steam function at the same point. So, this is from May 2010 question paper. So, velocity potential function. So, from the velocity potential function, phi equal to x into 4xy minus 3 equal to, we write it as 4x square y minus 3x. We have to calculate the velocity. So, for velocity, first you differentiate u equal to minus dou phi by dou x. So, minus of dou phi by dou x. Differentiate in this equation with respect to x. Minus of 4x square y. Differentiating 8xy minus 3x minus 3. Differentiating minus 3x equal to minus 3. So, substituting x equal to 2 and y equal to 3. Minus of 8 into 2 into 3. Minus 3 equal to minus of 45. Similarly, v equal to minus dou phi by dou y, which is minus 4x square, which is minus of 4 into 2 square equal to minus of 16. Now, velocity at this point, given point, v equal to square root of u square plus v square, which is square root of minus 45 square plus minus 16 square equal to 47.76 meters per second. And the steam function, to calculate the steam function dou psi by dou y equal to minus u. So, u we have calculated earlier. So, minus of u equal to 8xy minus 3. And similarly, dou psi by dou x equal to v, which is v we have calculated earlier. So, which is minus of 4x square. Now, integrate the second equation. So, we have the second, integrate the second equation with respect to x. So, integrating dou psi equal to integral 4x square dou x. So, psi equal to 4 into x cube by 3 plus a constant which is function of y. K is a constant which is function of y. Now, differentiate this equation with respect to y. So, dou psi by dou y equal to, differentiating first component is there is no y term. So, it is completely 0. So, differentiating k of y equal to dou k by dou y. So, we call it as equation number 3. Now, you compare equation number 1 and 3. Comparing equation number 1 and 3, dou k by dou y. So, dou psi by dou y equal to 8xy minus 3 and here dou psi by dou y equal to dou k by dou y. So, comparing 1 and 3, dou k by dou y equal to 8xy minus 3. Now, integrate this equation with respect to y. So, integrating dou k, integral dou k equal to minus of integral 8xy minus 3 into dou y. So k equal to 8x y square by 2 minus 3y, which is 4xy square minus 3y. So the psi function minus of substituting value, so psi equal to minus of 4x cube by 3 plus 4xy square minus 3y. So substituting x equal to 2 and y equal to 3, minus of 4 into 2 cube by 3 plus 4 into 2 into 3 square minus 3 into 3 equal to 52.3. So the steam function at the same point is 52.3. Example number 4, the steam function for a 2 dimensional flow is given by psi equal to 8xy. Calculate the velocity at the point 4, 5. So this is from May 2009 question paper. Psi equal to 8xy, velocity at the point 4, u equal to minus of dou psi by dou y, so minus of 8x, which is minus of 8 into 4 equal to minus 32. Velocity component v equal to dou psi by dou x, so 8y, so differentiating it is 8y, so 8 into 5 equal to 40. So the velocity v equal to square root of u square plus v square, which is minus of square root of minus 32 square plus 40 square equal to 54.23 meters per second. Example number 5. So from May 2006 question paper, a 2 dimensional flow field is given by phi equal to 3xy. Find the steam function and discharge between the steam lines passing through the point L and M. So it is given phi equal to 3xy. So velocity component from the velocity potential function. So velocity component is, so u equal to minus of dou psi by dou x, differentiating this minus 3y. V equal to minus of dou phi by dou y, which is minus 3x. And the steam function, which is dou psi by dou y equal to minus of u, which is 3y. And dou psi by dou x equal to v, which is minus 3x. So we call these two as equation number 1 and 2. Now the steam function is also given by d psi equal to dou psi by dou x dx plus dou psi by dou y dy. So substituting for dou psi by dou x from and dou psi by dou y from the previous expressions, d psi equal to minus 3x dx plus 3y dy. Now integrating this equation, so d psi equal to from the previous page, d psi equal to minus 3x dx plus 3y dy, integrating integral dy. Integrating on the right side, minus integral 3x dx plus integral 3y dy. So integrating psi equal to minus 3x square by 2 plus 3y square by 2, which is 3 by 2 y square minus x square. And the value of the steam function between the limit, the steam lines L and M, psi L equal to 3 by 2 yl square minus xl square, psi M equal to 3 by 2 ym square minus xm square. So the discharge is psi m minus psi l, which is 3 by 2 ym square minus xm square minus yl square minus xl square. So this is the discharge. So if you know the values of y and the x at the given point m and l, you can calculate the discharge in terms of numerical values. Example number 6 from May 2007 question paper. Do the following velocity potentials represents a possible flow? If yes, determine the steam function. So it is given phi equal to y plus x square minus y square. So we are given phi equal to steam function phi equal to y plus x square minus y square. So we calculate dou psi by dou x equal to 2x. So dou phi by dou x equal to 2x. Dou square phi by dou x square equal to 2. Dou phi by dou y equal to 1 minus 2y. Dou square phi by dou y square equal to minus 2. So for the flow, dou square phi by dou x square plus dou square phi by dou y square equal to 2 minus 2 equal to 0. So velocity potential function satisfies the Laplace equation. Dou square phi by dou x square plus dou square phi by dou y square is called as Laplace equation. So Laplace equation is equal to 0. The velocity potential function satisfies the Laplace equation. So the flow is possible. So for a possible flow, the Laplace equation should be 0. So with this velocity potential function, the flow is possible. So if the flow is possible, we have to determine the steam function. So steam function d psi by dou psi by dou equal to minus u, which is dou phi by dou x, which is 2x. Dou psi by dou x equal to v, which is minus dou phi by dou x, which is minus 1 minus 2y equal to 2y minus 1. Now, already we explained, different steam function may also expressed as d psi equal to dou psi by dou x dx plus dou psi by dou y dy. So, substituting dou psi by dou y and dou psi by dou x, so this is 2y minus 1 dx plus 2x dy. Integrating this equation, the steam function will become psi equal to integral 2y minus 1 dx plus 2x dy. So, this is 2xy minus x plus 2xy, which is 4xy minus x. So, psi equal to x into 4y minus 1. So, this is the steam function for the given velocity potential function. Example number 7 from November 2010 question paper. The velocity component for a two-dimensional flow field for an incompressible flow fluid is given by u equal to y cube by 3 plus 2x plus x square y, and v equal to xy square minus 2y minus x cube by 3. So that this represents a possible case of an irrotational flow. So we are given u equal to y cube by 3 plus 2x minus x square y, v equal to xy square minus 2y plus x cube by 3. For irrotational flow, the component omega z, circulation component omega z, 1 by 2 dou v by dou x minus dou u by dou y should be equal to 0 for irrotational flow, vorticity component. So, dou v by dou x, that means from this equation, dou v by dou x equal to dou u by dou y. So, from the two velocity components, we calculate dou v by dou x. Dou v by dou x equal to, differentiating this equation, v equal to xy square minus 2y minus x cube by 3 with respect to x, y square, so xy square differentiating, y square, second term 0 minus 3 x cube, x square by 3 equal to y square minus x square. Similarly here, differentiating with respect to y, dou u by dou y cube by 3 differentiating, y square, 2x is 0 minus x square y equal to x square, which is y square minus x square. So, from the above it is found that dou v by dou x equal to dou u by dou y. So, it is possible case of irrotational flow. So, it satisfies the vorticity condition. Example number 8. If the velocity field is given by u equal to 16y minus 8x and v equal to 8y minus 7x, find the circulation around the closed curve defined by x equal to 1, x1 equal to 1, 4, y1 equal to 2, x2 equal to 8, y2 equal to 8. And we are given u equal to 16y minus 8x, v equal to 8y minus 7x. So, dou u by dou y equal to 16, dou v by dou x equal to minus 7, and delta x equal to x2 minus x1, which is 8 minus 4 equal to 4, delta y equal to y2 minus y1, which is 8 minus 2 equal to 6. So, the circulation is given by tau equal to dou v by dou x minus dou u by dou y into delta x delta y. So, tau equal to minus of 7 minus of 16 into 4 into 6, which is minus 552. Circulation per unit area, so minus 552 divided by the area, delta x into delta y, so 4 into 6 equal to minus 23. Circulation per unit area. Example number 9 from November 2019 question paper. So, given that u equal to minus 4x into x square minus 3y square and v equal to 4ay into 3x square minus y square. Examine whether these velocity components represent a physically possible two-dimensional flow. If so, whether the flow is rotational or irrotational. So, we are given u equal to minus 4x, 4ax, x square minus 3y square and v equal to 4ay, 3x square minus y square. So, differentiating u equal to minus 4a x cube minus 3x square. So, modifying the equation, 4a into x cube minus 3xy square. So, dou u by dou x equal to minus 4a 3x square minus 3y square. And v equal to, modifying this equation, v equal to minus 4a into 3yx square minus y cube. So, differentiating dou v by dou y equal to 4a into 3x square minus 3y square. So, from the above, it is found that dou u by dou x plus dou v by dou y equal to 0. For a two-dimensional flow, the continuity equation is satisfied. So, the flow is possible. It is a possible case of two-dimensional flow. So, for the flow, now it is possible. Now, we have to check whether the flow is rotational or irrotational. So, for that, for irrotational flow, we have omega z, circulation, vorticity component, omega z equal to 1 by 2, dou v by dou x minus dou u by dou y equal to 0. So, that from the equation, dou v by dou x equal to dou u by dou y. Now, we have u equal to minus 4a x cube minus 3x y square. Now, we find dou u by dou y minus 4a into first component, x cube, differentiating with respect to y is 0, minus 3x to y, which is 24axy. V equal to 4a into 3x square minus y cube, differentiating with respect to x, dou v by dou x equal to 4a into 3y into 2x. So, differentiating y cube with respect to x equal to 0. So, it is also 24axy. From the above, it is found that dou v by dou x equal to dou u by dou y. So, it is possible case of two-dimensional irrotational flow. So, earlier we proved it is two-dimensional flow. So, in this slide, we proved that it is irrotational flow. So, it is possible case of two-dimensional irrotational flow. So, we stop here. These are all the books I published in mechanical engineering subject. You may find fluid mechanics in machinery. There are a lot of examples, solved problem available in the book, in the fluid kinematics. You can refer to the book for additional problems. And I upload the video lectures, all the video lectures in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the video for your better learning. So, thank you for watching. So, please post your comments on the comments box. So, if you have any queries on the subject, you can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number. I will sincerely answer. So, we will meet again in another video lecture on the subject fluid mechanics in machines. Until then, bye-bye.